Hi guys, let's talk today about the manifestation concept called be, do, have. A lot of times when we are manifesting something into our reality, we want to force it or we want to desperate our way into making it happen. Meaning if we think if we're desperate enough or we try hard enough or we force it hard enough that it will actually come. And the truth about that is the energy that you vibrate at is the energy of what you're going to attract more things. So if you are operating from a place of desperation or from force, you're going to attract more situations that force you to force things or to be desperate. If you're vibrating at an energetic state of being able to receive, of knowing that you're grateful, that it's already here, that it's already going to happen, even if you don't see it on the physical plane, you're going to attract more things at that energetic state to be grateful of, or more things that prove that it's actually going to manifest itself on the physical plane. So I really like the concept of be, do, have, because it kind of gives you the steps or the framework, so to speak, to follow to ensure that you can actually manifest your goal to fruition, all right? So the first step in be, do, have is to be. How can you be what you need to be to allow this goal to come to fruition? Meaning, how can you embody it? How can you align your life with it? How can you be in that energetic space? So for me, when I was writing my very first book, I had to be a best-selling author before I was actually a best-selling author on the physical plane. So I would ask myself certain things like, what would a best-selling author do? What decision would a best-selling author make? How can I be more of a best-selling author? And I allowed my decisions and my beliefs to align with that. A lot of times when I'm working with my client, we're talking about the be concept. We talk about what are 15 reasons that you are worthy of this goal. So I'll have them identify 15 reasons, and I say to them, which I'm going to say to you, don't get up until you identify all 15. Then stand in the shower or stand in front of the mirror with your hands on your hips in Superwoman pose and remind yourself 15 reasons that you're worthy of being this person, of having this outcome, all right? That is the very first step in the be, do, have process. With that be part, you're basically bringing your desired destiny into the now. And I think a lot of times people like to say it's faking it till you make it. It's not faking it till you make it. I like to say practicing until you make it. This is your ability to practice that you're actually ready to receive it. The second step is to do. How can you act in alignment with the outcome that you want to accomplish? There's a quote by Frederick Douglass, and I don't know it exactly like word by word, but I have the premise and the concept. And basically what he says is, I prayed for the same thing for 20 years, and I didn't get an answer until I prayed with my feet. Simply put, we cannot just say, I want something, sit down on the couch and wait for it to land in our lap. We have to take intentional and aligned action to be able to bring that thing into our reality. So what is it that you can do in alignment with the outcome that you want? For me, one thing that I like to do is I like to consider propellers and barriers. What are the things that I can do that are going to propel me in the direction of where I want to be? And what are the barriers that are pulling me or preventing me from accomplishing that? When I identify my propellers and barriers, I determine how I can do more propellers and how I can stay away or circumvent or move beyond those barriers that are going to prevent my overall success. Finally, the third step is to have. This is allowing you to just receive. Now, in order to get to this step, I have to tell you that you need to detach from the outcome. Now, let me explain detaching from the outcome, because a lot of times people think that they have to detach from the outcome and they have to act like they don't really want it anymore, or act like it doesn't matter. What detaching from the outcome actually means is you're detaching from the how and the when, but you can still hold tight to the what. You know what it is you want, you're drawn to what it is you want, but you're not so attached to the how and the how is it gonna happen or when is it going to happen, then now you're losing your footing, you're losing your grounding, and you're operating from a place of force or from desperation, okay? So in order to receive, you need to be open to receiving the outcome. And this is where I find that a lot of people block the manifestation process because they're not open to it. They think they're open to it, but a lot of times our limiting beliefs often surface at this point that prevent us from being open to it. For example, if you want to call in a 2K client, but you feel like 2K is too far-fetched or it's too extreme or nobody would ever pay that, you're always going to block the receiving portal here. And so what I find is that doing techniques to be able to open your receiving portal, to open your energy, to align your energy with what you want, is going to be so important. So the tool specifically that I like to use when I'm working on manifesting or bringing forth a goal is emotional freedom tapping. And emotional freedom tapping is so, so, so valuable. The way emotional freedom tapping works is it allows you to tap through 9 different meridian points. And basically what you're doing is you're tapping negative energy out and replacing it with energy that's going to help you feel fulfilled, help you feel empowered, and help you be ready to take on and tackle whatever you need to tackle and be ready to receive. If you remember earlier, I mentioned that everything is energy, and the energy you're vibrating at is the energy that's going to determine what you're also able to receive as a direct result of that, okay? So it is so important that you're taking care of your energy, because even if we think of like nature, in with water, in a stream, water has to move down a stream. And the reason it has to move down a stream is because still water eventually becomes stale or toxic. It's the same thing in our body. And that's why we end up harboring or carrying negative emotions such as frustration or bitterness or resentment. But that doesn't have to be you any longer. When you use tools such as emotional freedom tapping and the like, you put yourself at an energetic state to be able to align your energy with the outcome that you desire so that you can receive what it is that you want to receive as it relates to your goal, as it relates to what you're manifesting, effortlessly and confidently, okay? If you're looking for more support to get energetically aligned with the outcome that you want to manifest, I have an amazing option for you. If you use the link below, I have 2 different emotional freedom tapping bundles. One is tapping for abundance to really increase your money mindset and to call in abundance that you desire and deserve. And the second one is EFT tapping for productivity to increase your overall productivity so that you can increase your overall success as it relates to your goals. So you can use the link below so that you can sign up for either one or both of the emotional freedom tapping bundles. And trust me when I say you will never, ever, ever look back, because you'll never be the same. It's so transformational. So let's review one final time as it relates to you manifesting your goal. First step is to be. How can you be that person that is able to bring this goal to fruition? The second step is to do. What do you need to do that is aligned with the outcome that you desire and deserve? And the third step is to have. Allow yourself to be able to receive. And how can you get at an energetic state to be ready and willing to receive the outcome that you desire? I'd love to know below, so comment and let me know. And in the meantime, definitely check out those bundles, and I will check in and chat with you all later.